Hey guys, Joe here at Xbox Games, and man, it is a cold day out here in Xbox Studios, hence the beanie. Anyways, before we start on this, like always, guys, definitely subscribe if you guys haven't already. Make sure you guys give in on the giveaways. Again, you know, we give away some, we think, pretty cool stuff. Last guy won in, he got to choose between the Nexus and the Aeon Pro, and he went ahead and chose the Nexus Pro. So again, awesome to him. He even did a video on it. If you guys want to check it out there, I thought it was pretty cool. Didn't say much, but still, it was cool. Anyways, we're doing a review here on Nerf's Fortnite SG. Now, you know, this was a highly anticipated shotgun that I saw a few times on different sites saying, oh, this is going to be so awesome, this is sweet, and like all kinds of stuff. But, you know, when I got it here, I'm just like, oh my gosh, it's not what I thought it was going to be. But still, I want to break this down in case a couple of you guys out there are kind of curious about this, if it's something you want to add to your Nerf Fortnite arsenal. Now, we did do a Fortnite kind of review on kind of our Fortnite loadout with the current Fortnite blaster, so you guys can kind of check that out there. We kind of went over what we thought was the best of the best so far, but maybe we might redo it a little bit, right? Because that definitely needs an updated video with some of the newer stuff that's come out. Anyways, let's hop right in, take a look at the box of this. So boom, you can see the front of the box. I mean, this is actually a long box. I didn't really realize how large this blaster was until you kind of get it, right? Taking a look at it on the Walmart's website and things like that, you don't really get 100% idea of just how crazy and big this particular blaster is. So I was like, okay, yeah. Anyways, on the back here, check it out. Again, nothing too crazy. Kind of talks about the breech loading system. It does show, of course, over on the right, the BASRL as well as the SR, which have been out for a couple months, if not 6+ months, both which we thought were awesome blasters. And again, 4 mega darts. Nothing too crazy here on the back. It actually reminds me, like, this color scheme, it really doesn't remind me of like a competitive Nerf blaster, right? I thought this was going to be more like of their water pistol, like their water squirt gun types. I was like, oh my gosh. So when I first saw this, I was like, oh, that's just the squirt gun. I don't freaking want that. But I was like, oh no, that shoots mega? Cool, let's actually check it out. So let's hop in and take a look at this thing really up close. Again, I mean, nothing too crazy on it. I mean, they kind of just went very basic on this particular blaster. It's kind of the same theme that we've seen a lot with the Fortnite themed, Fortnite kind of line in Nerf, where they kind of left it like in the actual game, right? I mean, that's the whole point of it, is to kind of leave it like what it is, like in the game. Not too many frills, not too many gimmicks, but still, I mean, not a bad looking blaster. It's just kind of plain Jane, which I think is kind of cool. If we take a look, of course, at the grip, it's one of my big ones. It is a really, really good grip, either with right hand or left hand. I mean, it doesn't matter which side you are, it feels great. I think it is a good fit for larger Nerfer hands like mine, as well as, of course, little Nerfers like you guys, sometimes some of you guys out there. I think it's going to fit great. You are not going to complain about it. The stock, not too bad. Fits me well. Should fit a little Nerfer as well, too. Now, one of the things about this particular blaster that I'm like, oh my gosh, there are no tactical rails on here. They do have the quote-unquote iron sights up top. But for the most part, guys, there are no tactical rails. Side, top. But it's a shotgun, right? You just point it and you want to shoot like 5 darts down the line. But anyways, yeah, there are no tactical rails, which kind of bugs me. This is the same thing with the, the Dino Squad line here. None of those have tactical rails. What is going on? Like those, I'm like, you're Dino Squad, you're fighting dinosaurs. I mean, you better have some type of scope or something. So yeah, I just wish there was some type of tactical rail in here so I could stick my accessory, my whatever, you know, my sight, my whatever. You know, with this particular blaster, guys, the pump grip is not too bad. I envision somebody redoing this pump grip with a 3D printed part or something along those lines. It is easily accessible. You can pretty much, it's just 4 pins or 4 little screws to take off. So you can definitely open this thing up. So along the lines of the pump grip, it does have kind of the, whatever you want to call it, the dart opening door there. Now here's the thing. When you pull the pump back, as you guys can kind of see, look at this. Come on, just make it slide the door open, right? Save us a step. They did save us a step when you go forward. It does close it, but geez, just open it up when we open it, right? So I thought that was like kind of weird. I thought maybe mine was broken, but I watched other reviews and they were like, no, when you pull it back, it does nothing. You got to do it yourself. You got to load the dart in, which is crazy. Yeah, you got to load 1 dart in. That is my biggest gripe. Close it and then shoot it. And that's the thing, guys, is, you know, with a shotgun, oh my gosh, right? Either you need to shoot multiple rounds out of here, or it's got to be like the Saturn, right? The Nerf Rival Saturn, where you have multiple shots in this, and it was bump fire. You can't really bump fire this thing because it's one shot, but even if you hold down the trigger, it's not going. So I'm like, man, they like cut all the goodies and everything that you guys want out of this thing. I wish this was multiple shot. I wish you could jam like four of these down in there and then pump it, shoot, pump it, shoot, pump it, shoot. Oh man, that would have changed the game for this blaster. I do envision somehow somebody making something for this, but since the loading mechanism is just really weird and you got to go in there and shove the dart down in there and then go, I think it's going to be kind of difficult, right? Instead of a drop down and push style. So that's one of my biggest things about this. It's a single shot. Now, if it would have shot, say, 2 megas, hey, I wouldn't have complained. Shot 3 megas, that would have been awesome. 2 megas would have been freaking sweet. Or let alone let's shoot 3 normal darts out of here. That would have been a true shotgun style to me. I mean, they have, what is it, the DS-16 or something like that, and its little baby brother right here, where you're shooting 3 darts out of there. I mean, that's a shotgun. This is a shotgun. Let's shoot 3 darts. But I get it. They're probably acting like these are slugs or something like that. You know, you get the single shot out of there. But I wish it was a multi-shot. That's one of the biggest things I think that people are going to kind of talk about this and say, man, whoa, it is not a multi-shot. And I'm just like, oh, my gosh. Anyways, let's take a look at me shooting this particular blaster. We can switch it up here. Again, you are not going to be speed loading this thing by any means. I think for me, this is just going to be a prop that I'm going to set out, you know, around the yard when we have our Fortnite Wars, and just have it as something you could pick up. It's already loaded and you shoot it, maybe have a few rounds by it, and that's it. I don't really see many people using this as their primary, just for the sheer fact that, you know, you could shoot a jolt quicker than you could shoot this thing, which is crazy. So that's why for me, ooh, yeah. Anyways, the FPS, as you could see, it actually comes out of here decently fast. It's not too bad. I was actually relatively surprised at the actual, like, speed that it comes out. So I get that. It wasn't too terribly accurate, but I think it was a little more accurate than the smaller Elite darts, just because you have a lot more weight when it comes to these darts. So anyway, you can see me shoot, nothing too crazy, right? It's a single shot. Now, as it comes for the actual darts that come with it, again, it comes with 4 mega darts. It does have, and correct me guys if I'm wrong, I haven't seen this color combo on any other Nerf blaster that uses the mega darts. So it uses this orangish and purplish. I haven't seen this. And I compared it to the other darts, the other mega darts, and they're just the same, just a different color scheme, which I think is cool. And I want to kind of, again, compare this again to the Saturn, because I know some of you guys are going to talk about it. When it comes to price, of course, the Saturn is almost double the price of this thing. But, I mean, look at that. And I'll pull it up here. The Saturn is superior in so many ways, guys. I don't have to harp on the Saturn. I know a lot of people call the Saturn the Nerf Blaster of the Year, which was almost very close for mine. But, I mean, the thing is, with the Nerf Saturn, you got bump fire, you got multi-round, you got a cool look, and it feels good. They both feel great in the hands. Don't get me wrong. They both feel great, and you guys know that. But with the multi-shot and all this stuff out of here, bump fire, this just, like, takes the cake. But, again, if you are a Fortnite fan and you are looking to kind of stick, you know, with your Nerf Fortnite line, by all means, pick this little blaster up. It's a cool little one-shot. But if you are looking to get a little more competitive, someone's going to outplay you with this sucker. It is just, right, I could fire off 8 rounds by the time it's going to take for you to shoot 2 out of here. If you're lucky to shoot 2, right, you're going to shoot 1, try to open it, and I'm just going to run after you and blast you with this thing. But, again, I just wanted to compare those because some people were, you know, saying, hey, how does that thing compare? And I'm like, okay, check it out, man. Boom, it is almost the same thing, same length, same everything, except, of course, for the bigger rounds. Anyways, guys, that's my 2 cents on the Fortnite SG. The pump SG, just because, again, it's along the Fortnite line, and I like blasters that, again, come from games that you can kind of relate to. Let me know what you guys think. Let me know if you guys got this, if you've modded it, or what you guys think of the actual performance of it. I am always, always curious. It might be something I might mod in the future. I don't know if I could stick, like, you know, 3 or 4 rival rounds down in there and just shoot them all at once. That would be so freaking awesome. Anyways, guys, definitely subscribe if you guys haven't already. Come on. Get in on the giveaways. I've said it 1,000 times. Anyways, thanks again, Fox fans.